break from defenses. But in this case, it's the offense still throwing the football up big in the fourth quarter.
This Fournette territory here, and he's alone in the backfield on second and goal. Oh, now Godwin with a chance to run it. And he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Chris Godwin with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bucs offense continuing to pour it on.
Cause I went there when they ain't had a ball. He talk his body. Wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop. He don't like to pass the ball. That ticket, he talking thick hit. I was kicking in houses for it. Got two different tickets, right? Oh, yeah, they louder, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be couching, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the thousand, boy. They get too touch and they get too foul, boy. I'm talking you out of bounds, boy. They always screaming, reach me snap.
This is the NFL on EA Sports, and we are in the Pacific Northwest at Lumen Field in Seattle, Washington. These folks love their football in Seattle. This was the scene a moment ago as the home squad came out of the tunnel, and it was just absolutely deafening in this building. They're set for football, so are we, as the Seahawks get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Two teams that came into the NFL together back in 1976. The Seahawks and Bucks are underway. First carry for Leonard Fournette. Fournette, a first down, still going. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Leonard Fournette, 75 yards. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead.
Wow, first play in the game, CD, 75 yards. These people, they haven't even filed in yet from the tailgate lots.
Everyone talks about starting out fast. Everyone talks about getting explosive-type plays. That was absolutely a thunderbolt. And on the defensive side, you spent all week scheming, all week preparing, and it seems like it goes right out the window.
And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line.
If we had a dollar for every time we heard a team talk about explosive plays and how valuable they are, we probably wouldn't have to work very much. We just saw a big one there. And then they tried to go explosive again, going for two.
Yeah, is that a little too risky, you think? Just kick the extra point?
You know, I'm all about getting points. And if I feel good about my kicker, I go ahead and do that. But with that ball.
And he will score. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. That will tie the all-time mark. You cannot go further, folks. 109 yards on the kick return. And the Bucs get the quick strike touchdown. And now Coach Bruce Arians has made the call. His guys will go for two. They will run it. It's Fournette. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. So their second touchdown of this first half, they went for two after score number one. Didn't get it. Now they get the equalizer, so to speak.
So to speak. And you can understand the thinking. Because they didn't get it after the first score, they wanted to get back to a normal points pattern, get up to 14. But just think, if they missed it here, they're only up 12 to nothing. One extra point on the other side could ultimately beat you if they score twice.
Bradley Kenyon.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And they'll let that one go as it skips through the back of the end zone for a touchback. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Sliding out of the pocket. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free. I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
First and 10, it's Wilson. That's into the hands of his tight end, Will Dissly. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
I think that's how this defense is going to need to play these tight ends. Again, get right up on them and stay physical. And that paid off on that play, helping force that incompletion.
From midfield now, here's Wilson. Over the middle, that's caught by Metcalf. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. Wilson will throw again. And incomplete on the deep ball.
The scoreboard tells the story for him, a little bit bleak. And while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close. But the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Buccaneers defense holds, and they get the football back. They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 81 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. They'll toss it to Fournette. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
Throwing on first down is Brady. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. On second and 10, Brady flush to his right. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S, ball security.
And they preach it, They have it up in meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you've got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
From the 39, Wilson. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
That was not a real confident throw right there, and he's just 2 of 7 to start the game. Now he's going to have to find a groove with a big third down coming up. Let's see if his confidence can increase.
Steps away to his left, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Now remember, they were unsuccessful earlier in this first quarter. Going for it on fourth, they're going to try a second time. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. Rolling to his right. And it's going to be batted down. And we'll go the other way with a football. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. On first down, Brady. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And the Seahawks are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line. It had been a near-perfect beginning to this football game. Already a double-digit lead first quarter, but their first misstep.
And you know how it is, partner. Sometimes when everything's going right, you start to feel like you can do just about anything you want on the field. This one didn't work out. If I were him, I'd go to my defensive captain and say, pick me up, my man. Help me out.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down, being chased out left. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. 14-0 to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Wilson. And the catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 31-yard line. There's Wilson to throw. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off by Lavonte David. There he goes, left side.
Mike.
And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD.
Partner, what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well, yet they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick six. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. Oh, I think the Bucs got it, and they did. Tampa Bay football. Well, there you go. Just your everyday leading big and the onside kick it with the lead. They got it. I mean, it worked, but interesting call.
I think because they have such a margin, they feel a little bit bolder about what they're doing. And it's not only just to try and increase their lead, but that's their way of saying we're in full control of this game and we can kind of do what we want.
Here's a give to Fournette. And he's going to get this pretty close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Seahawks 42. On third down, Fournette. Fournette, first down, still going. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Leonard Fournette with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Buccaneers are able to add on to their first half lead. Well, what a first half he's had running the football. Another terrific run there, and this one finds the end zone.
Well, we know he's a guy who's capable of coming up with big plays in the running game, and his offensive line knows it as well. That keeps them motivated, looking for those extra blocks to give him room to run downfield.
And now Coach Bruce Arians has made the call. His guys will go for two. And someone a little too eager to block this extra point. Henceforth, the flag. So jumping from his free safety spot.
That tells you how aggressive they are on defense, doesn't it? They get everyone involved.